Direct from New York, welcome to Celebrity Cabaret. Today's guest celebrity, Dick Shawn. And now, your master of ceremonies at the Celebrity Cabaret, Richard Hall.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Celebrity Cabaret. I have very little to say other than that we have one of the most mystifying magicians in the world with us. He's the best magician in the world, and I really can't wait to get him out here. Harry Blackstone Jr. is with us today. I don't believe it. I don't believe it yet. Also, to top that off, we have a very funny man, which is the understatement of the year, who's probably considered a fine actor. He's been in so many films. He's the funniest guy around, ladies and gentlemen. Please welcome Dick Shawn. Dick Shawn! Right, you want a microphone?
Thanks.
Yes.
How are you?
Fine, how are you?
You want to hold my hand?
No, but you're grabbing it.
Oh, I'm sorry.
That's okay. The microphone is yours. Or would you rather work off of that?
I think I'll work off that.
Okay, all right. Well, I'll take my microphone.
Unless I can talk into your nose.
No.
Okay.
Dick Shawn, ladies and gentlemen.
No, please, no more applause. Please, no more applause.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. This is really a marvelous show. The whole idea of starting new people. I had just come from Las Vegas, and there they have all the established stars, all the great talents. I watched them all work. People like Sammy Davis Jr., people like Robert Goulet, people like Wayne Neuter. They're fantastic. They have, what do you know? They have so much talent, all these guys. So when we bring on new people, I hear the young lady that I'm going to introduce later is an extremely talented young lady, and I'm glad that she's there. And when I watch these younger people, I can't remember when I was a kid, before I was in show business, they're all getting started so young. When I was a kid, I had no ideas about show business. I wanted to be an athlete. Athlete. Yes, athletics, that was everything for me. God, as a kid, I used to play everything. Sports like basketball and hockey. But my favorite was boxing. I used to love to box. I remember I was about 18, 19 years old, working out in the gymnasium. 18, 19 years old, preparing for my intercollegiate championship bout. Man, I was just a kid full of energy. God, I used to love to fight. Excuse me, I had a cold at the time, you see. And I was working out there, knocking my brains out, and I noticed standing in the corner, watching me work out, was a rather fancy-dressed man. And I mean, he just walked over to me and he said, hi, big boy. And I said, hello, fancy dressed man. And he was fancily dressed, impeccably groomed. I've never seen a man with such a wardrobe. Had patent leather shoes, shiny silk suit, pleated white bosom, no shirt, just a pleated white bosom. And he said, I'm going to make you the heavyweight champ of the world. And I said, heavyweight champ of the world, sir? Golly, me, heavyweight champ of the world? But then I got to thinking, why not? Why not me? Why not me? Heavyweight champ of the world. Golly, I can see myself after 100 fights. My face on the front page after 100 fights. The first person I thought of was Mom. A little mother. Scrubbing floors in that old gym. Right there at my feet. And I looked down and I said, Mom, I'm going to be a fighter. The heavyweight champ of the world said I'm going to be the heavyweight champ of the world. You push a brush away and look at me and say, wow, when you everybody sing so wrong, won't you won? She was singing with Count Basie at the time. And she said, you be a fighter, son? You'll never fight. Fighting's not for you. You're too sweet. You're a nice kid. You'll never be a fighter. Never will you ever be a fighter. Be a fighter? You? Never. What do you mean, Mom? What do you mean I'm not a fighter? Let me help you, Mom. How do you think I'd feel watching you scrub them floors every night just for me to send me through school? Look at you. Let me get you a new home. I want to buy you a Cadillac, a new pail. She just looked up at me and said, no, son, fighting's not for you. Never will you be a fighter. Be a fighter, never you. You fight, never be. Makanuknu. Oh, makanuknu me, ma. Makanuknu you. I got a chance to be heavyweight champ of the world. Ready to deliver the heavyweight blow, and you'll stand up and yell, Makanuknu him? What do you mean I can't fight? Put up your dukes and I'll show you. Mom was yellow. I could have beat her easy. I went out and had my first fight, beat an Eskimo named Sam Makanuknu from Pittsburgh.
I want $500. I said, Mom, that's yours. Took the money, give me a little tap on the head, knocked me out cold. And that's why I became a comedian, you see. Anyway, I'm here not to make laughs. I'm here to introduce talent.
Hey!
Real talent.
But you're a real talent, ladies and gentlemen. Dick Shawn did this.
Walking, talking, singing myself. Never ever know the walking move. Getting fine.